So, first of all, I want to thank you for having me here at the presentation. Alona, Serena, and everybody else who is organizing this. And second of all, I want to tell you what who I am and what I am, what you will be seeing now, because I am from Argentina, but I specialize in street art. So what I do is I am a graphic designer and a certified tour guide, but since I have always been related to the arts, I was I'm a teacher, I was a dance teacher, I was an English teacher. I have done different things related to arts. When I started studying tourism, I was I started going out in the streets, and every time I saw a mural or something beautiful painted on the walls, I would take pictures and I would investigate what is that about. So I decided after a while of doing city tours and historical tours that what I really want to do is street art tours. So I investigated a lot on that topic. Now, how did I come to what I'm going to present to you? The name is The Power of Street Art. And how did I reach that point? It's when the pandemic began, I could not do my tours. And the guide association from Buenos Aires was doing some presentations from different guides who specialized in different topics. And they asked me if I could do one about street art. I had done my tours, but I didn't investigate on street art around the world. I had to do a lot of research. I did that. And I presented a presentation talking about the history of street art and how it began and all around the world. And that went great. And that turned into a virtual product. It turned into a product that I showed it in schools, in English, in Spanish. I would do it in different places for people to see on Zoom. So this is what I'm going to present to you today, because just a disclaimer, I am not going to show you Buenos Aires. I am going to show you street art and the value of street art for the tourism industry and for people in general, because I think I am a fan and I think it's wonderful. So that's my brief presentation. What I'm going to do now is I'm going to share it. I would like if people could put in the chat your name and what city you are from or what city and country you are from, so I could just see who is with me today, okay? So if everybody could just write down, I am Alona from this, or I am Simana from here, whatever. If you put it in the chat, well, I'm going to begin. Hi, Yoni from Israel. So just so you know why I speak English like as if I was from the United States, because when I was small, I lived in the United States and I also lived in Israel several years. So, but I was born in Argentina and I came back to Argentina, and that's where I'm living now. So let me, so let's see, we have Alon, Ukraine, Nail from Azerbaijan, Serena, Uzbekistan. Oh, it's quite difficult to pronounce all of the countries. So in the meantime, I'm going to share. Let me see. Optimize here. Share. Share the screen. Okay, so what you see in front of you is The Power of Street Art, and that's the name I gave to this presentation. And my idea is that at the end of the presentation, I want you all to realize why I'm calling it The Power of Street Art, and I think everybody will be able to clearly understand that when we finish the presentation. So now you could sit back and relax and watch this. Thank you. Okay, so what we saw here is that this is actually something that is very ancient, and walls were the first type of canvas on which people could express themselves with pictures and signs, leaving a mark of what they were seeking to communicate. And they used this for rituals. They used this to let, like, from, you know, prehistoric times, the hands on the walls, the animals. And this went on and on to all of the civilizations, to Egypt, to Rome, to everybody left their marks on the walls. Now, how do we get from there to street art as we know it today? The term graffiti, we all have heard the term graffiti. So graffiti is actually plural for graffito, which is in Italian, and it means to scratch on a surface. Now, this is what they did in ancient times. They scratched on the surface. But as we know it today, we see graffitis, and some people even confuse. They say they see a mural and they say it's a graffiti. And actually, I will tell you how there's a difference between the graffitis and the other types of street art. But what happened with the graffiti is that it began. Here we see a train full of graffitis, and this began in New York in the 1960s and 70s. And so these groups of kids or these individuals, they started writing with spray paint or with markers on the trains. And this became a terrible problem for the police, for the train system. This was a form of vandalism. So they would clean it up, and then the next day the trains would still appear again, all marked up with the graffitis. They call themselves writers, because for them, what they were doing is writing. They're writing their names, and the police persecution led them to move west. So they were in New York, and they started moving to California, where everything was much freer, and that's where they kept on developing this graffiti writing style. And the peak of it was in the 1980s with the hip hop movement. Now, what's the relationship between hip hop and graffitis? So what we call graffiti is the visual expression of hip hop. Just like rap is the musical expression, and breakdance is the expression in movement. So there are these festivals that they continue. If you Google graffiti festival, you will find festivals where people are painting on the walls, others are dancing, the rapper is singing, and this is the whole graffiti movement that's related very closely to hip hop. Now, if you check also, I'm going to be referring you to Google a lot, because there's a lot of information, and that's how I found most of my information. So if you Google, you will see that there are today many different styles and types of graffitis. There's different types of writing on the walls with different sizes and different forms. I'm just going to talk to you about three large groups. The first one is the tag. So when we see this, we don't understand it, except the one on the bottom that says King. But these are like the signatures of these writers, and they call it tag. Now, the word tag actually means identification, and we have it on the name tags, we have it on the price tags, and we have it on the hashtags. So today, when we are on social media and we say, please, can you tag me in your publication, or I tagged you, means to identify somebody. And this word has gained a different meaning in through the social media. Now, another large group, well, this is just to show you somebody, one of these writers, how they write, and it is amazing the different types of tags that there are. So this is just somebody writing their tag. Now, another type is what we call throw up. So throw up, you've probably seen these around your cities or in different places. This is a different type where it's these round letters with just, usually it's just one color inside and one color outside. It's very simple. And the idea is like they threw the paint on the wall, and that's how it ended up like this. And there's a third type that's called a piece that comes from the word masterpiece. And you could see why, because not anybody could do this. This is very elaborate, and it takes a lot of work and a lot of time. And there are different types with different colors, and many of them have a character in them, like the one we see here. So this is the masterpiece, which is called the piece. And the graffitis have developed so much that in 2019, the first graffiti museum opened up in Miami. Miami has a district for street art called Wynwood Walls. And in the district of Wynwood Walls, they opened a huge graffiti museum where you could see all the story of the graffitis, pictures of the trains painted, interviews to all of this is also something I'm going to recommend. If you're not familiar with Instagram, the best place to find information about street art is on Instagram, since it is a visual platform. And on the graffiti museum Instagram page, you will see a lot of interviews to people who actually were the graffiti writers, that they were like 18, 20 years old in the 60s, and now they're 60, 70 years old, and they are still alive, and they tell their stories. So, street art, post-graffiti. Some people, like I mentioned before, they say graffiti, murals, it's all the same. It's not all the same. Actually, street art developed after a graffiti movement, where more and more people started painting on the walls different things. So while graffiti focuses on letters, words, and symbols, street art focuses on images and messages, and it has an impact on the community. So we have these buildings, right? Now, how does this change when we put a mural on it? How does this church change when we paint it in vibrant colors? Or this corner in Athens, where he painted this owl. So this is real. This is not like made up. I found the before and after pictures, and I put them up for you so you could see the difference. And that's how street art actually livens up, and it can make you smile. It changes a neighborhood. Even a whole neighborhood can be painted, like this case in Palmitas, Mexico. So now I'm gonna ask you to do something. I'm going to ask everybody to take out your cell phone, and we are going to Google something. I'm going to make you work along with me to find something. So you are going to go into your go into Navigator, and you put Google, and you write the word street art, comma, and your city, for example. I put street art, comma, Buenos Aires. Then I'm gonna go to the images, because what I want to see are images. I don't want to see like text or PDFs or Word documents. I want to see images. And then they will show me images. So what I'm going to do now, I'm going to stop sharing for a minute, and I'm going to see, it would be great if you could put your cameras on while I'm going to give you 2 or 3 minutes to do this that I asked for to Google. And I want to see what you found. If you found any street art in your city. And if you don't find any in your city, write down a country, your country, or another city close by. And we can write in the chat, just tell me, I'll give you some time to look it up, and tell me if you were surprised or if you found something that you had already seen, because the truth is, so let's just put in the chat, did you find anything new? Did you find anything that you hadn't seen before when you are looking for street art and your city? Yoni, yes. I know there's a lot of street art in Israel, especially. Well, all over the place, but in Tel Aviv, there's a lot. Actually, I know there's street art all over the place.
I put Jerusalem in, and there's a lot of street art.
You want to show it like on your screen? Oh, where is that?
This is in the marketplace. During the day, these are shutters of stores. Of stores, and at night when they're brought down and it's all turning into music, and then it's all street art.
I hear you.
You have a lot of political...
muted?
No, I'm not.
Are you speaking? I can't hear you. Does everybody hear him?
Can you hear me?
I can't hear you either. So is this a problem that I'm having?
Oh, wow.
There
is a lot of reality art, street art.
So everybody can hear Yoni, and I cannot hear any of you if you are all speaking. So why could it be that I am not hearing you?
Алена, вы слышите Йони?
It's a lot of street art.
If I turn off my headset. Wait a second.
Can you hear me now?
I can hear you very clearly.
I think maybe it's something from the WebEx.
Can you hear me?
Yeah,
I can't hear anybody.
Okay. Maybe yeah. Grace has a problem with her sound.
Open, let me see.
Here are some of the shutters in the marketplace.
Now I can hear. I don't know
this
if anybody
is all
did anything.
In a very vibrant marketplace called Machane Yehuda. And this is at night, in the evening, when all the shutters close in the food stores. And then it's nightlife that starts there.
There are projects like here we have in Buenos Aires, the projects for people who did that when the curtains go down, they paint. So who else has something wants to show us? Who is that? Somebody's showing that. Could you, Tsunami Blaze? Okay, I see you're showing. Wow, I see several of them. So I just wanted to know, in Cairo, you have a lot. Oh, there's something very special that was done in Cairo by a street artist called El Seed, and he did a special project there. I will tell you about that later on. So. I'm going to go back to sharing, and I'm going to tell you something. So I asked Alona and Serena, I asked them how many countries are here, and to give me a list of countries. So they told me there were more than 30 countries at the forum. So I looked up, I did what you guys all did, and I prepared something just randomly with some of the countries. I'm sorry if I didn't include all of them. So I just wanted you to watch. This is our street art, meaning ours, those of us who are at the forum.
Just gonna stand there and watch me burn. Well, that's all right, because I like the way it hurts. Just gonna stand there and hear me cry. Well, that's all right, because I love the way you lie. I love the way you lie.
I can't tell you what it really is, I can only tell you what it feels like. And right now it's a steel knife in my windpipe. I can't breathe, but I still fight. While I can fight, as long as the wrong feels right, it's like I'm in flight. High off a log, drunk from my hate. It's like I'm huffing pain. I love her, the more I suffer, I suffocate. Right before I'm about to drown, she resuscitates me, she fucking.
Okay. Thank you, Itamar. So I hope you found your country or your city represented there. I'm sorry that I couldn't put everything there, but this is just to show you how much there is all around the world. It's really amazing. Now, the last images, obviously, you know, were about Ukraine. And this brings me to the topic of raising awareness. So street art is not only something nice to see that makes you smile, that makes you say, oh, look at that beautiful mural. It can also be used as a great tool for raising awareness. And in this case, every time I do this, every time I do this presentation, I change it a little bit according to the audience, according to where I am, who's going to be there, and also according to what's going on now, because everything changes. Even when I do my tours, I always, before the tour, I have to go on Instagram to see what the artist is doing now at this moment. And I also go down the street first to see what has changed, because street art is ephemeral. It can be here today, gone tomorrow. And it's also something that people can like tag. Another word, way of using the word tag, is when somebody writes, does a graffiti on top of somebody else's work, it's called to tag it. So there's many things that happen. Now, raising awareness, I always talk about this because it's very important. And so here we're gonna, let's Google it again. And I'm going to tell you what to do. We're going to write street art, comma, raising awareness. And I'm going to stop sharing. So if you could also turn your cameras on, I want you to see what do you find and write in the chat. Okay, so Sorokini, okay, you're asking how the policy of graffiti is in my country. I would rather answer the questions at the end so we could talk about different topics, okay? So put in raising awareness and write down what you find. What topics are used by street art to raise awareness? As soon as you find something, I would ask you to put it in the chat. For example, the war, that's the basic one that is now, there are, if you go in and you type Ukraine street art, you will find street art all over the world about the war in Ukraine. Love, we are in this together, right? What other topics? Who can write down something? Peace, environmental crisis, homelessness, right, social justice. Okay. There was a huge, this was even investigated when you saw one of the murals there, one of the slides had I Can't Breathe, or the whole what happened with George Floyd in the United States. That was also a huge topic for street art around the world. Climate change, right. What else? What else do you find there? How about women? And that's another huge topic, women. And violence against women, what's happening now, will certainly bring about also street art topics. Equity, correct. So this is something, a lot of pro against COVID, right? Save the Amazon rainforest. There is in one of my tours, one of the artists wrote, hashtag wetlands law, because in Argentina we are trying to get a wetlands law to save the wetlands. So it could be any, children is our future, it could be any types of topic. So what I'm going to go is back to the slideshow. I'm going back to sharing. So there are so many things I could show you here, but where our time is limited. So I decided, even though I'm not showing you something about, I'm not showing you the city of Buenos Aires, I do want to show you a little part of my, a little part of one of my tours. And just so you know, in when the pandemic began, a friend of a friend who's a psychologist, she has a website, and she was trying to put things on her website that would be comforting for her patients. So she asked me, I love you, I did your tour, because in 2019, I traveled to Europe and I saw a lot of street art, and I went to Berlin, I went to Prague, I went to Budapest, I was in Rome and Spain, and in every place I went, I did a street art tour. And that's what inspired me to create my tour. So I did my tour for Argentinians, for locals, and when I was about to begin doing it for tourists in March 2020, pandemic came. So lockdown, I couldn't do it. So this psychologist, she says, I want to put on my website some information and some videos about things that could make the people feel good, because in the pandemic, lots of people are feeling bad because they're closed, whatever. So I prepared a video, and this was before virtual tourism. By the way, in 2021, I started doing virtual tours on the Hago platform and then on different platforms as well. But this was before that. So I got together some videos and some things that I had, photos from my tours and videos, and I said, I'm gonna like show parts of my tours on video. So this is what you're going to see now. And what I'm speaking about is that there are different techniques used for street art. It's not only painting. So I'm gonna show you this.
Our tour begins at the Julio Cortázar Square, also known as the Serrano Square, located in the center of Palermo, Soho. Around the corner, we reach Santa Rosa Passageway and our first mural. What we see is a wall covered with papers, full of images and texts, some in black and white and others in colors, forming a collage. This mural was created using a technique called paste up that consists of preparing a design in the studio that can be drawn, painted, or printed with different techniques, and then pasted on the wall with weak paste using large brushes or rollers. The mural was created by a collective named BA Paste Up. The group is made up of five artists: Gerdy Arapos, Ale Giorga or Movimiento Petrus House, Guiche Pacello, Rusty Damas, and Boxy Trixie. Each of them has their own style, and most are self-taught artists. As you can see, the designs go from text that communicate social messages to different types of characters and figures. Even though each of them works individually, pasting their art on walls and free spaces around the city, in 2015, they formed BA Paste Up. And since 2016, they have been creating murals together, making their individual work much more powerful. Since paper doesn't last too long due to the sun and the rain, these murals must be restored regularly. On March 6, 2020, right before the lockdown, they got together to restore their murals in Palermo, and I was there to record the event.
Okay, so that was my little video that I prepared for her. So you can all see a little bit of me in action and this is called the paste up, but I'm sure there is paste up all over the place. And one interesting thing about paste up is that the artists can prepare their work. There was recently this year a paste up festival in Lima, Peru and Buenos Aires. The artists would send their work to the artists from all over the world, sent their work to a place, and the paste up artists here would paste it all on the wall. So, as I mentioned before, street art can make a smile, deliver a message, remind people about what is important, and if used wisely, motivate and inspire us to make a change. It expresses who we are and what we care about. It is there for everyone. This is the power of street art. So this is the idea behind what I was doing, and I hope everybody could understand it. This is my Instagram and my Facebook, and what I'm going to type in the chat is my link tree where you have all my social media. But one more thing I would like to do now, let me stop sharing, is I'm going to, since we do have a little bit of time before the questions, I'm going to ask you to go into, well, those of you who have Instagram. I don't know if everybody has Instagram, not everybody uses Instagram, but if you have Instagram, then go into, look for a tour with Grace. Okay. And that is my Instagram account. But what I want to show you is the following. I wanted to talk a little bit about festivals. If you Google festivals, you will see that there are a huge amount of festivals all over the world, street art festivals. Now, I had the opportunity of going to one this year. Last year I decided that the next time I travel, besides traveling and visiting countries, I'm going to go to a street art festival. So I was going to travel to Europe. I went to Europe in June, and I Googled and I found out that there was a beautiful festival in Grenoble, France. So that lasted a month. So I said, great, this festival lasts a month. I could go for a week just to check out the murals. Then I saw on their website that they were accepting volunteers. So I said, oh, I'm going to be a volunteer at this festival. So I signed up and I made my stay longer. I stayed for 12 days and I was a volunteer at the festival. So if you look in my Instagram, you would have to scroll down quite a bit. Let me see if I could, no. You have to scroll down and you will find, well, maybe you could do this later on. You will find the videos, because I'm not sure that I could share that with you here. You will find the videos of my stay at the festival, and you will see how they were painting the murals, actually. I'm going to give you a link now to check. This page has street art festivals all around the world. So if you go in there, you will see the best street art festivals, and you will see that there are festivals all around the world. So this is interesting for a tour guide as well, because maybe you have a festival close to where you are and you could show the people, look, why don't you go there? Who is this? Oh, we are celebrating the Angel Festival today here, Feast of Archangel Saint Michael, Gabriel, and Raphael. Okay. And is there art at the festival? So if you go into that chat, I'm also going to put up here my link tree. So in my link tree, you have all of my social media. You have my Instagram. My website is under construction, but you have my Instagram and you have my my Facebook and my YouTube, where there are some videos as well. So I'm going to open this up for questions now. If anybody has any questions. You can either talk, raise your hand, or you can, there was a question in the back in the chat before that somebody asked me about the policy of graffiti in my country. That was Sarojini Imran. Where are you? Can you show up? If not, I will just answer the question.
Зарина, переведи, пожалуйста, вопрос.
Здесь просто написали вопрос. Из Индонезии девушка написала, и она вот зачитала сейчас и спрашивает, она здесь или нет. ее имя назвала, а может, она не услышала. Wait, I will... Как это ее звали? А, Сараджини Имран, is there? Oh, okay.
I'm here, I'm sorry, because I used my phone. So thank you very much for the presentation, Grace. I love it. I really like graffiti, actually, but in my country, it's the problem is pro, and some is not agreed and some agree. And our country, I mean, the government is not really accept the graffiti, not all the things, just a few of them. And that's why it's the potential for the tourism, actually. I agree with you. But how can we manage for the graffiti? And maybe you have many experiences from many countries that you visit, yeah. And which one is the countries are very good for support for graffiti artists, and how they do that, the management in the country, in their country, I think. Yes, thank you.
Okay. I don't know all of the policies in all of the countries. I know that as we move on, every time there is more and more street art all over the place. Obviously, one of the basic places was Berlin, where the Berlin Wall was a place where people would put graffitis and murals all over the wall. And that is actually a place where you go visit today and you see a lot, and it was an inspiration for many people. And there is actually, if you Google, you will see the best cities in the world with graffitis. You will see many, many cities, and many places are adding on to the graffitis. I mentioned an artist before. His name is El Cid. Let me see if I could write this. I suggest you look this up. He is an artist. His family's from Tunisia, and they moved to France when he was very young. And when he was 18, he wanted to learn about his origins, so he started studying Arabic. And when he started to write, he found this that he loved writing it. It was like drawing, because the Arab writing is like drawing. So he created this this type of graffitis that were letters. And what he does is he sends messages. Everything he does these huge murals that are beautiful. And if you Google him, you will find El Cid. You will find beautiful pieces of work. And he actually does projects, social projects, because all of his, since what he does is writing and it's beautiful, all of his work has a message to humanity, a message of peace, a message of help, a message of solidarity. So he actually did this huge project in Cairo. That's why I mentioned it before. Right outside Cairo, there is a city that's called the Garbage City, where all of the garbage from Cairo goes. And so he painted this huge mural on the houses that you could see from a mountain. Beautiful. And that you could only see that from a certain place from this garbage city. So he does a lot of social projects with calligraphy. He calls it calligraffiti. He writes it like this, calligraffiti. He learned Arabic when he was already older. He speaks French, and he learned Arabic when he was older. And this really touched him to learn about his heritage, speaking of what Simana told us earlier. So I don't know what the policy is in each country, but I do know that every year more and more cities are being full of paintings and murals. So in my city, in Buenos Aires, since people started putting things on the wall for political reasons many years ago, the government does not prohibit writing on the wall or painting on the wall. If you come into agreement with the owner of the wall, like I have a house, I want to paint a mural, I call them an artist. They paint it. Nobody can tell me that I can't do that. There is no legislation against it, as long as we are in agreement. Okay. And the public walls, if the government decides to do a project, paint on public walls, then there's no problem there. Okay. So I hope I answered your question.
Зарин, переведи мой вопрос, пожалуйста.
Thank you. That's good. The good information for me.
Okay. Any other questions?
Yes.
Thank you.
Grace, there is another question from Alena.
Yeah. Okay,
В Украине есть несколько школ по арт-искусству уличному.
There is several schools in Ukraine for art, street art.
Street art schools.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Wow.
Но какие-то разнообразные мелкие рисунки никто не делает. Делают большие муралы.
But little pictures nobody making. They are making only big pictures.
И их не так много в городе.
There is not so much street art in the city.
Потому что один мурал рисуют 10-20 человек.
Because the one big picture making 10 or 15 people.
They do it together.
Yeah, they are making together.
Может быть, вы посоветуете, потому что у вас в стране это очень развито, как бы им вместе взаимодействовать, потому что это интересное направление в арт-искусстве и туризме в том числе.
Maybe, Grace, you will suggest how they can collaborate, for example, with your country, because it's a new and very interesting, how to say it, industry, street art.
Mm-hmm.
And you, how you can work with...
How you can collaborate with... I don't know, but I think it would be interesting to connect. Mm-hmm. And since I do these, what I'm doing now, this presentation, I also do it, actually they called me from, I told you, from several schools, and I did for children in the schools, I did this presentation for the art classes or even for English, because English and Spanish, and last year I did it for the first time live. I went to the school. I didn't have to, since they were allowed after the pandemic closed off everything. So I did a presentation at the school for 100 children that were sixth graders. And what I do is I tell them what's going on around the world. I did the same as here, but a little bigger.
Hello.
And it would Hello? Be interesting.
Yeah, Yoni.
Yoni. What I was saying, Alona, is it would be interesting if I get information, if we speak and I can see what you are doing there, I could show this in my presentation here, and mm-hmm. we could do a collaboration in a Zoom meeting, or I could do it live for the children to see what's going on and what you're doing actually there in the schools. I don't know if that's what you mean. If not, we could speak afterwards. And see what kind of project we could do together.
Ален, перевести?
Я, в принципе, поняла. Спасибо большое, Грейс. Я спешусь еще с вами отдельно.
Thank you very much, Grace. I will text you privately.
Right. Okay, yeah, great. I think we can talk mm-hmm. and we can see what we can do together. That would be great.
Okay, thank you very much.
Okay, I don't know if Yoni wanted to say something.
Yeah, I wanted to say thank you very much. It was inspiring. It was something that I'll keep my eye open. Here we have a lot of graffiti tours in Jerusalem yes. and Tel Aviv. And mm-hmm. Banksy was here and did his impression on different walls. Yeah, thank you very much. It was eye-opening.
Thank you. Thank you so much. Banksy is also here now. I think he's ending already. I went to them. I know he painted there on Gaza Strip, and he did different projects there. And here we have, there was an immersive show of all of Banksy's work now in a huge place. I went to it. I was like amazed. If I suggest you all, if you don't know him, you look up Banksy. He is actually amazing, the things he has done. And he's one of the pioneers, actually, that began in Bristol in the 90s, I believe. We still don't know who he is, his face, but his work is actually very, very interesting. So thank you.
Thank you very much, Grace.
Okay. Any other questions?
Is there any other questions? I think no, everything is clear, and it was really interesting. Thank you very much.
Okay, so what I would want to say is that if anybody wants to contact me, I'm going to put my WhatsApp number here.
Mm-hmm. Yes, if you want please. And your email address also.
And my email address. Mm-hmm. Is
okay.
So if
на сайте выложены номера телефонов и имейлы всех спикеров.
Okay, thank you very much, Grace.
If anyone has any questions or anything, just contact me. I am open to talk, to even to arrange things together. Maybe, you know, like do a something with the two of us together in different countries at the same time. There's many things that can be done. So just let me know. And thank you again for inviting me. And it was very inspiring to be here, even though I couldn't see many of the things because for me now it is almost 9 a.m., but you began at like 4 a.m. my time. So I'm sorry I couldn't participate with everything. So, and stay tuned now for Kelly from Brazil.
Thank you. It was a Grace Berfain guide from Argentina. So, <Argentina. laughs> thank you.